Good day, everyone. My name is Bill Smith with the U.S. Geological Survey. I am currently the NHD point of contact for Region 2, which includes Louisiana, Texas, New Mexico, Arizona, Oklahoma, Colorado, and Utah. Today I'd like to spend a little time discussing the flow network in the National Hydro Data Set. We'll discuss the Utility Network Analyst tool, and finally we'll discuss the NHD flow table, which may be ordered with any NHD data set you wish. First, some basic concepts concerning the flow network in the NHD. Only NHD flow line feature class features will participate in any NHD network. Other NHD feature class features: NHD points, NHD lines, NHD areas, NHD water bodies, or any of the event features will not participate in the NHD network. Flow within the NHD is based on the HydroNet Junction feature class and is a node-to-node or junction-to-junction navigation system. Connectivity is key. For NHD flow line features to participate in the network, they must be connected. There can be no gaps, no breaks, or missing features. Connectivity is the key. NHD flow line features should all have the correct flow direction. There is an attribute for each NHD flow line feature, which may be set to width digitized or uninitialized. All features attributed as width digitized will participate in the network. If a user is unsure of the flow direction or other information concerning any NHD flow line feature, those features may be attributed with uninitialized, and they will not participate in the network. Flow direction in the NHD is initially determined by direction of vector collection. In other words, flow direction is from the start junction to the end junction. With that said, any NHD flow line feature may be flipped to correct the flow direction. In this example, I've opened up an ArcMap session and an ArcCatalog session, and I'm showing the HydroNet Junction feature class. Again, the HydroNet Junction feature class must be present for flow network to work within the NHD. There are many issues that affect features from participating in the flow. Incorrect flow direction on any NHD flow line feature. Gaps or breaks between NHD flow line features. Missing NHD flow line features that create a gap or a break, isolated networks, and finally the unattributed, uninitialized versus width digitized attribute. In this example, I'm showing incorrect flow direction and how that might affect the network. You will notice most features flow from west to east in this example, except for the one feature highlighted in yellow. I have purposely flipped that arc incorrect for this example. What would happen if I was attempting to trace downstream on any feature to the west of the yellow highlighted flow line feature? Flow would move downstream until it hit the incorrect direction, and then it would not move any further. That would prevent this small group of features from participating in the larger network. In this example, I'm showing a gap between the stream river to the west of the large lake. This gap between the stream river and the artificial path going through that lake pond would prevent the network. To the north of the large lake, you'll see a missing NHD flow line feature between the lake and the stream river. Of course, flow may not flow through a feature that is missing. Here we have an example of isolated networks. These networks are all over in the NHD and are correct to be there. If we were 100% certain that this small isolated network should connect to the larger network, we have the ability to add a connector that would allow the isolated network to connect to the larger network. Here we have an example of uninitialized versus with digitized. You will notice many features attributed as uninitialized. They will not participate in the network. You will also notice many features attributed as with digitized. They will participate in the network. The Utility Network Analyst tool was developed by ESRI and is included in every copy of ArcGIS. To open the Utility Network Analyst tool, there are various methods. In this example, I'm highlighting the View button found in the main menu area. I'm then selecting Tools from the drop-down menu, and then placing a check mark to the left of the Network Utilities Analyst tool. I may also simply hover my cursor over the gray portion of the main menu area, mouse click, which drops down the drop-down menu, and again I'm placing a check mark to the left of Utility Network Analyst. Both methods should display the Utility Network Analyst tool. I'm highlighting the HydroNet Junction feature class that must be present for the Network Analyst tool to operate with the NHD. Going through the Utility Network Analyst tool, I'm dropping the drop-down menu from the Flow button. You'll notice my first option is to display arrows for the Flowline feature class. If I select the second Display Arrows button, it will place an arrow indicating direction of flow on all features participating in the network. Finally, if I select the Properties button, it will open the Flow Display Properties window, which allows a user to set symbology for determinate flow, indeterminate flow, or uninitialized flow. We'll now look at the flag barrier tools. You'll notice there's an add junction flag and an add edge flag tool. The difference between the junction flag and edge flag would be the location of the point where the action will start. To use the junction flag, I must place the point at a junction of two NHD Flowline features. I personally prefer to use the edge flag tool simply because I don't have to zoom in as far, and I can locate that edge flag tool at any point on an NHD Flowline. You'll also notice the junction barrier and the edge barrier tools. These tools will prevent flow from going through any feature that they're placed upon. In this example, I've set an edge flag on an NHD Flowline feature. I've set my trace path to trace upstream, and I've selected the Solve button. All features that participate in the network upstream from my edge flag placement will now be highlighted in red. I've cleared my results. I've left my trace task as trace upstream, and I've set a barrier tool just below the dam on the large lake. Once I hit the Solve button, you'll notice that the network flows up to the barrier tool and does not flow through that feature. This is very handy for modeling flow real-world flow through the NHD. Moving on to the Analyst button, I have several options. I can disable various layers, the NHD flow line, or the HydroNet junction feature classes. I can clear any flags I've set, clear my barriers, clear my results. I also have the Options button, which allows me to select various options. I can set weights. I'd like to highlight the Drawing versus Selection option in the window on the lower right. In the example on the left, you'll notice I've left the Drawing button highlighted. I've set two edge flags on particular NHD flow line features. I've set my trace task to find path, and when I hit the solve button, it finds all features between the two edge flags. On the right side, you'll notice I've changed drawing to selection, as opposed to drawing a red bold line indicating the flow. It now selects the features that are participating in this particular query. In this case, I've opened the flow line table. I've placed my cursor over the length KM column in the flow line table, right mouse clicked, and I've selected statistics in the drop-down menu. This allows me to determine the total length between the two edge flag tools that I've placed. In this example, 82 kilometers. Again, very helpful in modeling with the NHD. There are various trace tasks available for a user in the Utility Network Analyst tool. I usually use the trace upstream, trace downstream, or find path. And finally, the solve button. Very critical to complete any query I've set up. I'd like to point out that working with the ESRI Utility Network Analyst tool is completely user interactive. It cannot be programmed. It is user interactive only. Here's a screen print of the NHD flow table, which may be ordered with any NHD order you place. The NHD flow table is created for users to program outside of a geographic information system. It represents the same connectivity as the HydroNet junction, but may be used outside of a GIS. To order the NHD flow table, when placing an order, I simply have to place a check mark to the right of the include flow. If I'm curious what is the flow table, I may select the What is Flow button to the right. Here's an example of the flow table showing the FromCom ID to the ToCom ID. Again, the flow table is very useful to analyze NHD flow outside of a GIS. That concludes this portion discussing NHD flow. I'd like to say if anyone has any questions, please feel free to contact me, Bill Smith, at 303-202-4493. Thank you.